Hey guys, we're here today looking at an ATCA chassis and demonstrating the use of the candlestick sensor with regards to measuring air velocity and air temperature. So as you can see, this is a standard 14 slot ATCA chassis. We pull the card in question out and we have the candlestick sensors put in distinct locations everywhere across the board. With regards to locations that we want to characterize and measure airflow. So here we have the card out of the chassis, and we have several candlestick sensors placed at certain locations throughout the board, locations of interest. And with the candlestick sensor, you can outfit it in the chassis itself to measure inlet velocity coming in through the inlet of this airflow of this panel here. And then you can also measure the airflow leaving the chassis. So you can do a total chassis characterization, or you can go down to the board level and to the component level. So as you see here, this is the board and component level. We have a candlestick sensor at the inlet of the board, measuring the inlet air velocity and air temperature. We also have a candlestick sensor at the outlet of the board, which measures outlet air temperature and outlet air velocity. But this location, strategically, was meant to be placed in front of this heatsink, so you can then measure the outlet air temperature and outlet air velocity. So talking about that, we can lead into the component level. So here we have a candlestick sensor, so we can measure the inlet air velocity and inlet air temperature. This way you can do one of two things. You can characterize a heatsink that's already in the application, or you can use the candlestick sensor to design a heatsink before it's on the board. So you can put candlestick sensors at different points of interest on the board, and you can determine what the inlet airflow velocity would be to the heatsink and the temperature. As you may know, this is very important to heatsink design. Those are two very important parameters, along with power and others. So then you have the outlet temperature here of the copper heatsink, but that then turns into the inlet temperature of the next heatsink. And then you also have the outlet of the maxi flow, but mostly the board overall as well. So next we can show you some data points running this board here with some mock heaters. And we can characterize these heatsinks and see what we get. Okay, so we just turned the IQ200 on here, where the sensors are connected to, and the thermocouples that are embedded in the heatsink. So now the spike here in temperature at the thermocouple plot is the startup of the fans and the heaters at the same time. And that is the fan in the chassis and the heaters that are located underneath the heatsink to mimic a component. So it's going to keep growing here until we get to steady state for the temperature, but the air temperature will keep reading in with the temperature that the sensor is seeing, so as well as the air velocity. So these will keep reading live, and they will switch back and forth to reading temperature and then to velocity. So you'll see a real-time data stream of both air temperature, air velocity, and then heatsink temperature as well. And now you can see we're approaching steady state here, and this is where the experiment concludes, where the heatsink has reached a steady temperature. And now this is how you can characterize heatsink for this given power.